this technique is for the iliotibial band. So essentially we're trying to do some of the work that the IT band would have to do in controlling that lateral pelvic motion. It's quite a hard one to get good purchase on the lever. So we're going to spiral around the shank here initially first. But the other purpose for doing that is that there is a suggestion that some of these iliotibial band syndromes, for example, stem from some instability at the superior tib fib joint, which leads to some excessive activity in the biceps femoris, and that can perhaps cause some irritation of the reflection of the nerve and set up almost like a neurogenic pain through there. So we're going to come in and address that underlying factor of that instability, if you like, by getting some force closure through that superior tibiofibular joint first. But the main part is to get hold of this lever crossing the hip joint as well, so we're controlling this lateral pelvic motion at the same time. So we're using the wider tape. We're covering quite a few joints here, and we really do want this energy storage and release. So we're going for the original tape that's got that stronger recoil. And we're going to start over that head of the fibula. It's important to be careful of the common peroneal nerve and that we're not creating compression. And obviously we need to warn people if they're getting pins and needles or numbness, that they need to remove it, it may be too tight. If you really hook underneath the fibular head, you're probably more likely to cause that compression directly on the nerve. So if we're coming right over the top of everything, we're a little less likely to get that. We're then going to bring the leg up, get our anchor point on, sweep around with our tension on to create that force closure. Can then come in underneath, and here we now have to just angle this a little more to run. Just straighten out for me, Aaron. Run this up that iliotibial band. We can even go a little posteriorly with a little knee flexion if we do think that that biceps femoris is overactive. So we can do a little knee flexion, get a little knee flexion moment in there as well to reduce the activity of that overactive biceps, if you like. Then we're going to come up over the greater trochanter. We can keep this intact in one piece, and that's going to resist that hip from dropping into adduction. The other option is, once we get to the trochanter a little bit superior to it, is to actually split the tape through the middle. You okay holding there, Aaron? And that gives us two bands to work with here, because our iliotibial band has contributions from our tensor fascia lata anteriorly and then our glutes posteriorly. So what we can then do for this anterior band is bring them into some flexion as well as we run this further across through the front. And then we can bring them into some extension at the hip as we do the gluteal band. And we want to try to get this as much as we can behind the axis of the hip joint. Difficult once we've gone over the trochanter. So what that means is that when they're in flexion, this posterior band is going to be tightening up and contributing some force through the system, and then when they're in extension, the anterior band will contribute. So no matter what range they're in flexion and extension, we're still going to be getting a nice contribution into this iliotibial band to resist this hip dropping into adduction. Again, come and give it a nice hold, particularly where that crosses any of those hollow areas. You may want to use the spray to maximize your adhesion, and then good holding on the end for 30 seconds or a minute to maximize that bonding.